Hello and welcome to The Agenda. I am Ajay Kaul. Today we will talk about India gradually becoming self-reliant in defense sector. The Indian Air Force will get 83 advanced Tejas fighter planes, which have been developed and manufactured indigenously in the country. This decision by the Cabinet Committee on Security was described by Defence Minister Rajnath Singh as a game changer for self-reliance in the country's defence manufacturing sector. So how is it a game changer? We will discuss and analyze this aspect in the agenda today. We have with us retired Group Captain of the Indian Air Force, M.J. Augustine Vinod, and Dr. Prahlada, former distinguished scientist of the DRDO. But before we begin our conversation, let's have a look at this small report.
The Cabinet Committee on Security, headed by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, has approved a proposal for purchase of 83 advanced light combat aircraft Tejas for the Indian Air Force. The fighter aircraft are indigenously developed and are being manufactured by the state-owned Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. The 83 aircraft will be brought from HAL for rupees 48,000 crore, and the delivery is expected to start 3 years after the deal is formally signed. The entire consignment is expected to be delivered by 2028-29. These aircrafts are expected to bolster the combat potential of the Indian Air Force, which has been facing acute shortage of fighter planes. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh said the deal is a game changer for self-reliance in the Indian defence manufacturing sector. The deal for the 83 Mk-1A jets will take the total number of Tejas variants ordered by the Indian Air Force to 123. The 40 LCAs already ordered by the Indian Air Force are in the initial operational clearance and more advanced operational clearance configurations. The LCA Mk-1A will come with additional improvements over the FOC aircraft, making it the most advanced Tejas variant so far. The Mk-1A variant is expected to come with digital radar warning receivers, external self-protection jammer pods, active electronically scanned array radar, advanced beyond visual range missiles, and significantly improved maintainability. This is the largest deal for procurement of an indigenous defense system and can be seen as a major boost to self-reliance in the defense sector. Bureau report.
Now let's welcome our guest, Dr. Prahlada and M.J. Augustine. Welcome to the program, both of you, sir. So let's begin by asking M.J. Augustine. So when you see the decision being taken about LCA, 83 LCAs being procured for the Indian Air Force, how do you see this decision?
Good evening, Ajiji. It's an historic day. Yesterday was an historic day. You know, some historic days you will realize that it was an historic day after a few years.
Right.
This has been the single largest, you know, shot in the arm for Atmanirbhar Bharat, and going forward, the biggest money that has been pumped into the Indian defense sector.
Right.
73 fighters, 10 trainers, and go along, and the electronic suite to go along, the radar to go along, air to ground weapons to go along. It is no mean feat. And there's Aye Durustai. For the kind of expenditure that we are doing on defense, we should have been Atmanirbhar at least 2 decades ago. But better late than never. Right. We have leapfrogged a few decades. And if someone wants to compare LCA with Rafale, it's not a correct
I'll come to that question later on, but let me ask Dr. Prahlada about, you mentioned about we should have been Atmanirbhar 2 decades back. Dr. Prahlada, you have been with DRDO, and who knows better than you? So, as M.J. Augustine said, we should have been Atmanirbhar 2 decades back. What do you say on that?
Yeah, we had started actually about 3 years ago. We started with the engine of 34 aircraft, and we had hit almost the mission scale. And
suppose the last minute, the last mile effort, probably the airport, the government, we start to work together, and we meet the opportunity, we have to come to the aircraft, walk the field before we get to go. And then the next major effort done is for the LCA, and the LCA is to work right on for nearly 1 or 2 decades. So we should have got it done only 10 years ago at least. So now at least I'm happy. Government has taken a bold step. The airport has agreed. We are all happy. SAIL is happy. And we will have our own fighter jets which are as good as this.
But Dr. Pralada, you said that we should have been, it should have been done maybe 2 decades back. But what happened? Please explain for the viewers.
No, any aircraft, fighter aircraft, military aircraft development takes nearly for 3 decades, even in the rest of the world, Western world.
Right.
So probably 2 decades was a little ambitious. At least a decade ago we should have done it. I agree. That's possible, but we took time to do the testing, flying, and then we had to depend on the engine. You know, basically, the engine is not indigenous. So it took some time to arrive at the engine for aircraft. It took some longer time than what we planned. So at least we are a bit delayed, but I am happy at least now we have got taken a lead.
Okay, Crew Captain Vinod. As Dr. Pralada mentioned, that about the engine is not indigenous.
The history Russian engine started at the factory of Rolls-Royce over a snooker game. The Russian scientist, Russian general won a game, and he wore rubber shoes, and under his shoe he got the shavings of the first metallurgy from the Rolls-Royce to produce Russian engines. See, engine production and engine making of an engine is a very complex subject of metallurgy, and it takes years of experience.
I can understand that it is a very complex issue. I mean, subject of developing engine. But my question is that if so many countries can develop, why can't Indians? We have all the brains, I guess, or much better brains.
I totally agree with you.
Yeah.
See, Kaveri started off on a very right note.
Right.
But
Kaveri engine for the viewers. Kaveri engine. Yeah.
Kaveri engine.
Yeah, for the viewers. Yeah.
Kaveri engine started on a very right note. But somewhere down the line, the enough impetus to continue in the direction that it took originally was probably not given. I do not know the reason, Ajayji. And honestly, I do not know the reason. But I can tell you this much. G404, the engine which LCA uses now, is one of the very reliable and a proven engine. If you look at modern fighters, it is conglomeration of equipment from the subject matter experts producing and the companies producing a particular vertical. Even this LCA is going to be a shot in the arm for 500 plus Indian companies and some foreign companies. You take any aircraft for that matter. You take Mirage 2000. Mirage 2000 clock comes from America. How many people know this? So there are many such verticals that the aircraft manufacturer, they outsource it to other companies.
Yeah, that's
take Maruti car.
That's understood. That's understood. Yeah, that's understood. Ancillaries will be, procured from somewhere else. But maybe I will ask Dr. Pralada about why we couldn't develop engine on our own, since we have all the brains.
Yeah, Ajay, I will tell you, today we have in the world engines coming from UK, France, Russia and USA. Yeah, China is trying to catch up and they are coming to us, not perfecting, at least their operations. So there are 4 countries who are handling the gas turbine engines in the whole world. Now, we started this engine very, very often. And definitely, DRDO did a good job, made the engine. it worked, it was fitted in the aircraft, it tested. The only problem they ended up was weight was more than what the LCA was designed for. And Vinod is telling is the HF technology. Everything is the highest HF technology. The material, the processing, the machining, then the integration, lubrication, the temperature problem, the aerodynamics, thermodynamics, everything is HF technology. So, the focus of DRDO and ADA was how to make an aircraft, flying aircraft, flight control system, aerodynamics, flight control, then the actuators, the avionics, the missile. There are so many. So, engine became one of the elements. And fortunately or unfortunately, you can say, the engine was readily available, but was made by sitting our. So, the moment you had an engine working exactly the way you wanted, so the focus got slightly reduced for the engine, and we were focusing more on aerodynamics, flight dynamics, control system, flight control loss, avionics, like that it went. And the production of the out in the fabricate. So, probably the stress required for an engine was slightly reduced when compared to stress for flight control, or the structure, or the slider. So there is, the engine team was making gains and compared to that. So then with GE404, Air Force is happy. They said, let us go ahead with it, let us start changing the engine, let us focus on it. That's how it happened.
Okay, Group Captain, Defense Minister Rajnath Singh today has said that it's a game changer. Is it a game changer? And if yes, how?
Okay, this question has two parts.
Yeah.
One is game changer for Atmanirbhar Bharat.
Yes.
And game changer for offensive punch of the Indian Air Force.
Right.
Okay. So in the game changer for Atmanirbhar Bharat, certainly it's an historic day. Yesterday was an historic day. I mean, so much of money in a single project has not been pumped in the history of Indian existence. But now coming to the game changer
in an indigenous project.
It's an indigenous project.
Yeah.
But now if you look at apples to apples comparison, it is a single engine fighter like a Mirage 2000. It has the indigenous weapons like Astra 1, Astra 2, Astra CCM, that is within a very good complement of air-to-ground weapons like SAW, and another GPS-guided weapon is coming in a big way. So all this put together, it is a big jump for the aeroplane that it is replacing, which is MiG-21. But if you compare that with a new generation fighter, it is not a good comparison. It cannot be a good comparison. To start with, the RCS is slightly on the higher side. It is a single engine fighter. The external ordnance carrying capability, you cannot compare it with a Rafale. But then if you look at the operational application energy, there are many roles that an aeroplane performs. The role that is envisaged for LCA is more than what it is replacing. The MiG-21 fighter, which was essentially air defense and a tactical air-to-ground aeroplane. So this jump, if you look at the jump that LCA is giving, there is no doubt it is a game-changing jump.
Right.
But do not do, my humble request is, do not do a comparison with other modern fighters. It is not an apples to apples comparison.
So, since we talk about technology, so Dr. Pradada,
yeah,
could we not have developed a plane like Rafale? As Group Captain just mentioned, that it cannot be compared with a fighter plane like Rafale. What holds us back?
Yeah, I'll tell you. The first fighter aircraft, they are plane, Tejas, LCA, is incomparable in my category, in fact, you are putting here to F-16. And as you may have come across, F-16, USA took 4 decades to make it perspective. Now, we are talking about Rafale, and we have only one team in the country, that is ADA and DRDO together, making it. So the whole focus was making such aircraft, single-seater, single-engine, and this is what we focus on. Now we are taking the second version, which is a higher version, where we are holding an advanced lead multi-role combat aircraft, the AMCA AMCA, we call it AMCA, which the DRDO ALA is now looking at it. It will be in many ways surpassing the capabilities of Rafael. It surpassed the capabilities of him. We have a second aircraft, now we are taking off. So it takes some time, sometimes the first generation we made aircraft, Tejas is now inter production. The team has already been formed by DRDO, HAL, ADA to make the advanced multi role combat aircraft, which will be a bigger aircraft with two engines, bigger capability, better weapons, better control system. It will be a lot of AI driven, you know.
But Dr. Pradada, what is the schedule of that project?
Schedule, I think, knowing the experience of LCA Tejas, this aircraft will take approximately 15 years.
15 years from now?
Yes.
Okay. But by then the technology would have gone much beyond, no?
No, it won't happen. See, there is no what is the concurrent development taking. For example, today, in a fighter aircraft, the artificial intelligence is not embedded. But by the time next 5 to 8, 10 years, artificial intelligence will be embedded. So you will have aircraft with AI coming, you know, by the time it is operating. So that is where our ingenuity, our capability, competence comes. As we develop the aircraft, we will upgrade the technology elements, materials, parallelly, simultaneously, so that I will not miss the bus.
Right. So, Group Captain, you heard Dr. Pradada talking about the upcoming project, which will be like much ahead. What do you want to say on that?
Ajayji, AMCA is like some time away. First that is going to come out will be the next version, the LCA Mark II, which will be in, you know, you can roughly compare it with Gripen E kind of capability that will have, that it will have. But what I envisage AMCA will be, that it will have a lot of stealth capability. So that is something that we should look for. But I'll tell you a good news. And it is important that you, our viewers also understand this. And that good news is the scalability of the modern fighter. You know, earlier to upgrade a MiG-21, MiG-21 went through just one upgrade from Bis to Bison. Right. Because it was not upgrade of aeroplane which was of that era. But today, most of the aeroplane, the modern aeroplanes are completely. Upgrading an aeroplane is a week's job. To integrate any new weapon is a piece of cake because the bus is same, the bus address is same, the way you call the weapon is same. So integrating any new weapon, see, eventually the business end of any aeroplane
I think
is
the new,
weapon it launches.
I think the new things are only the stealth power and maybe weapon carrying system, isn't it?
Absolutely, sir. Yeah. Absolutely. So, I'm just comparing what happened earlier and what is happening now. You couldn't easily integrate a weapon to MiG-21 because it required a certain amount of wiring change, certain amount of center of gravity issues. Modern aeroplanes are fly-by-wire. Modern aeroplanes have a wide... So, you integrating a weapon becomes easy. Integrating any other new avionics suite becomes easy. Suppose a new generation of radar comes up. We can remove this radar and put a new radar and keep the addresses the way it is calling the rest of the system same. And voila, in a week's time, you have an aeroplane with a brand new radar. So, scalability of fighters, modern fighters, is good. So, AMCA will start off as A, but it will, as it is getting integrated into Indian Air Force, it will become B. And maybe 5 to 7 years down the road after the first cotton gets integrated, it will become C. And that is the case with most fighters. You look at the Rafale that we have and the Rafale that French have. जमीन आसमान का अंतर है दोनों के बीच में. आर रफाल इज मच मच बेटर इन टर्म्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक स्वीट, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक वेपन कैरेज कैपेबिलिटी, इन टर्म्स ऑफ क्रूज कैपेबिलिटी, इन टर्म्स ऑफ वेट, एवरीथिंग इज डिफरेंट. सो दैट इज वॉट आई एम सेइंग द स्केलेबिलिटी ऑफ फाइटर. So the question that you asked, that by the time 15 years we come out with AMCA, the technology would have taken leapfrog forward. To a certain extent, you are right, but we would catch up, and the technology you know is a catch up game.
Right.
When on XR it was the newest, and today it is the oldest.
So if you talk about maybe exports, so is it exportable, the LCA?
Ajay.
So that question came to my mind last evening.
Yeah.
And that question is a very good question. Yes, it is exportable, but not to not to the countries that we want to export. Probably countries who cannot afford a Rafale like fight, and to countries which has very low budget, and the countries which require very less number of fighters. So to that, those countries we can certainly export.
Yeah.
But if we think big countries are going to buy,
I don't think so. Big countries will buy. I'm talking about maybe South Asia, East Asian countries like Vietnam, Philippines, Malaysia. Dr. Prahlada, you wanted to say something?
Yeah. What I want to add, what Vinod is telling, it is really happening. That is, as the aircraft is developed, it's getting updated almost on right. This technology is called digitalization.
Right.
The design of an aircraft has become digitalized. That means you have everything digitalized, so you can upgrade the material, upgrade the engine, upgrade the radar, upgrade the flight control law, the weapon, literally on the go. So the way we did the aircraft, now will be totally different, and I feel that we will be able to bring out an aircraft which is state of art by the time it comes.
We all hope, sir. So, but when I was just asking group captain about the exportability of this plane, the LCA Tejas, what do you say on that?
Even the LCA itself already many countries have shown interest to buy it from India.
Yeah.
Government of India is thinking and looking at how to do it or what to do or not.
I'm talking about in the context of the reliability and capability of the system. Is it worth exporting? Because have we conducted the feasibility studies? Is it reliable to be exported as an export material?
Of course, why not? See, if you see the aircraft, last year, so you should have gone and seen the F-16 flying demonstration and the LCA Tejas demonstration. You cannot make out a difference. The quality, the reliability, and the maintainability are equally good. And we have one very fantastic record of LCA, that is the Touchwood. As of today, aircraft development, we have not got a single crash. See, it's a very big achievement. No crash, no failure of an aircraft in these last 20 years of flight. It's a big record and very good record. So we have the maturity, the competency, maturity, to make the aircraft is available between ADA, DRDO, HAL and industry. Today we have support of today for this aircraft, there will be 600 industries going to participate in production this year. 600 industries. So you can imagine the technology backup available in the country.
Right. Group Captain, you wanted to say something?
Yeah, I have first-hand experience on this, Ajay.
Yeah.
I was still in
Please share it.
And I have tweeted about this earlier also. And I was, very pleasantly surprised the way this aeroplane, stood out so beautifully, whether in terms of air-to-ground firing.
Have you flown
whether
it?
Whether it was in... Sorry?
You have flown it?
No, I didn't fly it. Okay. I was the director at that time.
Okay.
And its performance is as good as in terms of maintainability, in terms of performance, whether air to ground is concerned or air to air is concerned, within its scope. I was really, really surprised. I mean,
so what are its advantages?
It didn't give us any problem.
What are its advantages?
Maybe maintainability, like he said. You know, we call it the percentage, serviceability percentage. You know, in the NFOs, we call it a serviceability percentage. Though I will not name the percentage, but it was one of the highest that we saw at that time. So it is easily maintainable, and I attribute that to two reasons, Ajay. Yeah. One, the way we have designed this aeroplane, you know, it is easy, easily maintainable architecture that we have followed. That means the downtime is less. And a modular forward, including the engine. Engine is also a module of the aeroplane. So changing the engine or changing any equipment which has gone unserviceable, it is a piece of cake. And secondly, being indigenous, the spares are available easy. So, all put together, that is the biggest advantage, Ajay. That's why I was so excited.
If we talk about a combat situation like we had on 27th of February 2019, like when the fighters were scrambled, where would LCA stand?
I know where you will ask me this question. Comparing JF-17 with LCA is like comparing a Ferrari with a Bullock car. JF-7, both moves, and there ends the similarity. And that is what one of my flight commander who retired as Air Marshal said so today morning. So, you can't compare both. With Astra 1, Astra 2 now getting integrated, and Astra CCM getting integrated, if 27th February like situation happens again, I think Pakistan will have to phase out F-16.
So, it won't be of no use, LCS, in that situation.
Pakistan will have to phase out F-16.
Phase out?
We would have shot down all of them. All of them.
Okay. Dr. Pralada, I also want to ask about ALH, the helicopter. If we talk about how...
Yeah, you can talk. I want to add only one small point about...
Yeah, please.
I want to add regarding the cost, you know, you said about the cost. There are two parameters. One is called availability of the aircraft.
Right.
Availability of the aircraft is very high because we are producing everything in the country. So availability is very high, number one. Number two is what is known as the ownership cost. That is purchase cost plus maintenance cost over the lifetime, over the complete lifetime. See, our aircraft is much lower cost than anything available in the world market. So, these are the two major factors which will be very attractive for anybody to buy this aircraft. Whatever you talk LCA today, tomorrow you talk AFTA, it will be attractive to many countries in the world.
Okay, so we had to close. One last comment about ALH, Dr. Pralada.
Yeah, tell me what is the...
No, my question is, what is its efficacy?
Efficacy, see, ALH had its problem. In the beginning, there was a question of reliability and availability, both was a question. But of late, last few years, HAL has removed all problems. Now it is serial production is on, technical problems have been solved, and the helicopter has been given to free and for many applications. And in India, one advantage we have experience in high altitude, low temperature, desert conditions, warm climate, and this helicopter has done a wonderful job of late. It will also have many customers. I think we are crossed the hump, thanks to its effort, and this aircraft is another successful.
Yeah, I asked this question because that is also crucial to our self-reliance, Atmanirbharta. Yes. But time of this program is over. Thank you both of you for participating in this debate today.
Thank you, Ajay. Thank you. Thank you, Vinod.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
This is all in the agenda today. Thanks for watching. I'll be back with another important topic tomorrow. Till then, goodbye.